Oh my god.
Hi! Mom, we're in the middle of a campaign!
You mean the end? 15 after.
No! Oh my god. We have to go. Mom, wait! Just 20 more minutes.
It's a school night, Michael. I just put Holly to bed. You can finish next weekend.
But then I'll ruin the flow!
Michael.
I'm serious, Mom. The campaign took 2 weeks to plan. How was I supposed to know it was gonna take 10 hours?
You've been playing for 10 hours?
Dad. Don't you think that 20 more...
I think you should listen to your mother. Daggum piece of junk.
Be out there right now. We should be helping look for him.
We've been over this, Mike. The chief said...
I don't care what the chief said.
Michael.
We have to do something. Will can be in danger.
Well, more reason to stay put.
Mom!
End of discussion.
So, me and Barb are going to study at our house tonight. That's cool, right?
No, not cool.
What? Why not?
Why do you think? Am I speaking Chinese in this house? Until we know Will is okay, no one leaves.
This is such bullshit!
Language.
So we're under house arrest? Just because Mike's friend got lost on the way home?
Wait, this is Will's fault?
Nancy, take that back.
No! You're just pissed off because you want to hang out with Steve.
Steve?
Who is Steve?
Her new boyfriend.
You are such a douchebag, Mike!
Language!
Nancy, come back. Come back! It's okay. It's okay, Holly. Here, have some juice, okay?
You see, Michael? See what happens?
What happens when what? I'm the only one acting normal here. I'm the only one that cares about Will.
That is really unfair, son. We care.
Mike!
Here we go.
I hope you're enjoying your chicken, Ted.
What did I do? Hey, what'd I do?
And macaroni. Okay. Ted? Is that you?
Just me, Mom!
Mike? What are you doing home?
1 second! I don't feel good. I woke up and my head, it really hurt bad. And my throat was all scratchy and I wanted to tell you, but the last time I told you I was sick, you made me go to school anyway. And...
Michael.
Yeah?
I'm not mad at you.
No?
No, of course not. All this that's been going on with Will, I can't imagine what it's been like for you. I want you to feel like you can talk to me. I never want you to feel like you have to hide anything from me. I'm here for you. Okay. Is there someone else here?
No.
Something wrong with the meatloaf?
Oh, no, I had 2 bologna sandwiches for lunch. I don't know why.
Me too.
It's delicious, Mommy.
Thank you, sweetie.
So, there's this special assembly thing tonight for Will at the school field. Barb's driving.
Why am I just hearing about this?
I thought you knew.
I told you, I don't want you out after dark until
Will
is found.
I know, but it'd be super weird if I'm not there. I mean, everyone's going.
Just be back by 10. Why don't you take the boys, too?
No!
Don't you think you should be there? For Will?
Sorry. It's bad.
It's okay, Holly.
Nice. Oh, Jesus, you scared me.
Oh, I scared you?
I know, I should have called.
Where have you been? We agreed on 10.
After the assembly, some people wanted to get something to eat. I didn't think it'd be a big deal.
You didn't think to call and let me know? With everything that's been going on?
I didn't realize how late it was. Okay, I'm sorry, Mom. What more do you want?
Hey, wait. Whose sweatshirt is that?
Steve's.
Steve's. So is Steve your boyfriend now?
What? No, it was just cold, so I borrowed his sweatshirt. It's no big deal.
Nancy.
What?
You can talk to me. You can talk to me. Whatever happened.
Nothing happened.
I brought you a casserole.
Oh, thank you. You wanna... We'll always love Christmas.
Yeah.
So I thought if I put the lights up, somehow he'd feel like he was home somehow. It's silly, I know.
No. No, it's not silly. How is Jonathan holding up?
You know, he's good at taking care of himself. He always has been, you know? He thinks I'm losing my mind.
Something the matter?
No, we're having electrical problems.
Joyce, I want you to know something. If you need anything, anything at all, Ted and I are here for you. Just let me throw in that casserole, okay? Oh, where's Holly?
Hey! She shouldn't be here.
Oh, I'm sorry. She's quite the explorer these days.
Wait, did you see something?
Yeah.
What did you see? Tell me, what did
Joyce.
You see? What?
Joyce.
Listen, Karen, thank you for the casserole, but I need you to leave. Okay?
Fire's body was found in the water of this quarry by state police earlier this evening. He was discovered by State Trooper David O'Bannon just after dark. Now, state police are mounting an investigation to determine Fire's cause of death, but an initial inquiry...
Should I go down and talk to Michael?
Give him time. He'll come to us when he's ready.
Monday morning by his mother. Now, Byers isn't the first person to drown in Sattler's quarry. You'll recall only 7 years ago...
Michael? Hi, honey. How are you feeling?
I don't think I can go to school today.
Well, that's fine, sweetie. I need to drop off Nance, and I'm going to check in on Barb's parents. Why don't you grab a book or something? Come with me. You can stop by the video store on the way back, pick out whatever you want, even R-rated.
I think I just want to stay home today. I mean, if that's okay.
Well, are you sure you're going to be all right here by yourself?
I think so.
Okay. But if you need anything, call Dad at work.
Bye.
Bye, sweetie.
You lied to the police.
I didn't lie.
How naive do you think I am? You and Steve were just talking?
We slept together. Is that what you want to know? It doesn't matter.
It does matter.
No. It is all bullshit. It has nothing to do with Barb, and she's missing. And something terrible happened to her. I know it. I know it. And no one is listening to me.
Sweetie, I'm listening. I'm listening.
No, you're not.
Nancy.
Just leave me alone.
What's that guy doing?
You don't think?
Well, I know she and Steve have been spending some time together, so I thought maybe... Well, is he home? Maybe you could ask him. I'm sorry. Can you just hold on, please?
Michael!
I'm on the phone. I've told you a million times.
Just schedule any repairs.
What?
Is there anyone supposed to come and do repairs on the house?
Well, I don't understand. What, is there something wrong in the
Mom,
house? Do I need to call
in
my
the
house? One second!
Mark! We need to leave. Right? Now.
Michael!
If anyone asks where I am, I've left the country.
What? My son is hiding this girl?
What happened to her hair?
We just need to know if you've seen her in the past week.
No.
No. Absolutely not. Our son with a girl? I mean, believe me, if he had a girl sleeping in this house, we'd know about it. Wouldn't we?
This girl, what has she done?
I'm afraid I can't answer that.
Oh my God, is she Russia?
You can't treat us like this.
I need you to stay calm.
You come into my house and you tell me that my son is hiding some girl and that he's in danger, but you can't tell us why? And you what, you expect me to remain but calm? Mm-hmm.
I understand how upsetting this is. I wish we could tell you more.
They expect us to just sit here like prisoners. We should be out there looking for him.
Honey, we have to trust them, okay? This is our government. They're on our side.
That man gives me the creeps. Nancy, you don't think she's involved in this too, do you?
Nancy with Mike? No. No.
Dinner, I want you to pick out your toys for the yard sale.
Fine.
Two boxes worth.
Two boxes?
You heard me.
I'm fine with you giving away a couple, but the other ones just have way too much emotional value.
Emotional value?
They're hunks of plastic, Michael.
You already took away my Atari.
If you didn't want to lose more toys, you shouldn't have stolen from Nancy.
I didn't steal, I borrowed.
Oh, and you didn't curse out Mr. Kowalski last week either, right? Or plagiarize that essay? Or graffiti the bathroom stall?
Everyone graffitis the bathroom stall.
So if your friend jumps off a cliff, you're gonna jump too?
Look, we know you've had a hard year, Michael, but we've been patient. This isn't strike one. This isn't even strike three.
It's strike 20. You're on the bench, son. And if it had been my coach, I'd be lucky to still be on the team.
Two boxes. Two.
Solid. Hey, Mom, I was thinking about staying the night at Stacy's tonight. We were gonna have a girls' night. Romantic comedies, do our nails, gossip.
Sure, that sounds like fun.
I don't know, Kath. Maybe if it was Margaret Thatcher, that'd be another story. Just a second, Kath. Ted, can you get that, please? Sorry.
I got it.
No. Where the hell is he?
Karen, where's our son?
Wills!
Wills.
No one's picking up there. Nancy. What about Nancy?
Karen, where's Nancy?
Allie!
Allie's. Our children don't live here anymore. You didn't know that?
Seriously?
Am I done here?
Son of a bitch. You know, you're really no help at all. You know that?
Hey, language!
Hold on, please.
Oh. Hi.
Hi.
I didn't realize Nancy had a sister. What's so funny?
I'm Nancy's mother.
No.
Yes.
Mrs. Wheeler.
I'm sorry, and you are?
Billy Hargrove.
And you must be here for Nancy.
Nancy? No, not my type. No, actually, I am looking for my little sister, Max. Goes by Maxine. She's been missing all day, and to be honest with you, I'm worried sick, you know. I thought she was at Lucas's, but Mrs. Sinclair said your house is the the designated hangout, so, you know. Here I am.
Their driveway is pretty dark this time of night. So drive slowly.
Always.
And when you see Mike, tell him to come home already, okay?
You're a real lifesaver, you know that.
Anytime.
I'll see you later.
Yeah, just a sec. Mike!
Phone! Okay.
Hello?
It's 9:32. Where are you?
Sorry, I was just about to call. I can't see you today.
What? Why not?
It's my Nana. She's very sick.
But Hop said that your Nana was okay, that it was a false alarm.
Yeah, that's what we thought it was at first, but then she took a real turn for the worse.
Oh.
Yeah, we think she might die.
What?
Mom, get off the phone! How many times?
Did Nana call?
No, Mom, just get off the phone!
Ladies, she's coming down. And showtime.
Afternoon, Billy.
Dig the new suit, Mrs. Wheeler.
Thank you.
Jill, I gotta use the restroom. Will you watch Holly for me?
Sure thing, hon.
Thanks. Billy? Billy? If you're angry with me. But I shouldn't have said that. Billy. Billy. Please, will you talk to me?
Stay away from me, Karen.
To be honest, I wasn't thinking about him. I wasn't thinking about anyone, really. I wanted to be right. I wanted to be right so badly.
And were you?
I thought so. But maybe I just don't want to admit that I'm wrong, because if I'm wrong, then...
You're what everyone thinks you are.
Just a kid who has no idea what she's doing.
But you're not like that. You're a fighter. You always have been. I honestly don't know where you get it from.
Dad.
I think you were swapped in the hospital, to tell you the truth.
No. I get it from you, Mom. I get it from you.
Well, wherever you get it from, I'm proud of you.
Proud of me for getting fired.
That you stood up for yourself. That you stood up to those shitheads.
Mom.
Yes, those shitheads. And if you believe in this story, look at me, Nancy. Finish it. Then go and sell it to the Indianapolis Star or whatever. I mean, can you imagine their faces when they read a story about their own town in a big paper like that?
That would be pretty amazing.
So why not? Why not?
Finish it.
Your arm's inside.
Uh-oh, Dad can't get out now.
Why do you two enjoy torturing me?
Because it's fun, though.
Yeah, Dad, because it's fun.
Look, here we go.
Oh, boy.
Why are we stopping?
Because I slipped Jimmy a five.
What?
Come on, these are the best seats in the house.
The best seats in the house.
That was pretty, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh.
Mom, the trees.
What, baby?
The trees.
The fireworks. Look at the fireworks. I don't think they're here yet.
You three up against the wall!
No, where are they?
Oh my gosh, I can hardly keep track these days. They were at Dustin's, then Lucas's, and Max's. Do you know how it is? Summer!
Yeah, probably getting into some kind of trouble.
Last warning, you two, up against the wall!
Hold the ride!
On your life, Magnum!
Holy smokes.
Michael, I know your D&D club is tonight.
Hellfire.
Why don't you just call it the high school dropout club?
I want you home no later than 9 tonight, okay?
Yeah, okay, I'll try.
No trying. I need to go to bed early tonight.
Why?
It's a 6:30 flight, Michael.
Yeah, I know, but...
No buts. 9 or no California.
And no sweetie pie.
Mike! Let's go!
Jesus! How am I gonna survive a whole week without you guys?
9!
Remind me, when do they become reasonable human beings again?
Morning, guys!
Everything okay?
Yeah. Yeah, everything's okay.
I think it's so sweet that you guys are sticking together like this.
Could try sticking together at a different house for a change.
You know you're welcome here anytime.
Totally. You're like family. May I?
Absolutely.
Yeah, why not? Take us for all we're worth.
Okay.
Arrived first on the scene. We made our his body. It was
what are we even doing? I mean, where is the FBI? There was an eyewitness. That's what I want to know. We got a serial killer on the loose here.
In our power to find him. In the meantime, for your safety, we will be enforcing a strict curfew.
That's your solution? Hide from him? Where
are spreading through our country like some disease. A lie designed to conceal the truth. And now this cult is protecting its leader, Eddie.
And what exactly were you all doing at the lake?
We were just going for a walk.
A walk? At 9 p.m.
To the lake. We're gonna take a little swim. Little night swim.
Dusty, someone was just murdered there.
Yeah, we didn't realize that till we got there.
That's why we didn't swim.
And Nancy, was she with you at this night swim?
No.
Yes. We're not sure.
She was there.
Then she left.
It's all a little confusing.
And that's when you guys came.
Right, and then they dared me to say what I said.
Oh, yeah.
About the killer.
You're lucky you didn't get shot.
Have you had any contact with Eddie? That psycho freak killer? God, no. Nope.
No, we haven't heard from
absolutely
him in ages.
Not.
We barely know the guy.
Who?
Oh, that's a bunch of bull.
Erica!
I mean, you realize they're lying. The whole couch is on fire.
Erica!
Just the facts.
Are you lying to these policemen, Dusty?
No!
Lying to the cops is a crime, son.
I'm not lying.
The fire is consuming us.
Threaten them with a little jail time. Maybe that'll loosen their lips.
Okay.
Do you want to send our kids to jail?
We need to take this seriously.
He didn't mean it like that.
I should have agreed.
What is that?
See, Lucas, this is what's happening. Shut up. Okay. Shut up!
Jesus.
We're going to try a more civilized approach. One at a time.
Break it to you, Mrs. Willer, but they lied to you.
Liar, liar, pants on fire.
Molly.
We don't think they're actually involved with this Eddie guy, do we?
I think at this point anything's possible.
Our children are not murderers, Ted.
Don't put words in my mouth. See, she does that. Twist my words.
You're calling the theater?
The police.
Are you hearing this? They're now calling it a doorway into hell.
Great. More hysteria. Just what we need.
Well, it's the news. Now indistinguishable from the tabloids.
Hey, Nance. I found some more of your old stuff in the attic.
Mr. Rabbit.
It's okay if you want to save him, you know.
No, he'll be more loved in a new home.
Someone order a pizza?
Pizza?
Thank you.
You are never going on vacation again, you hear me? In fact, you can forget about college. You are staying right here.
Mom, it's snowing!